Okay, assalamualaikum and a very good day to everyone. Okay, so this is a recorded session, okay, for class on 5 o'clock on Friday. So our topic for today will be based on binomial and Poisson distribution. Okay, so for this time, I'm picking another example. Okay, that comes from sample final exam on April 2019, okay? So I'm going to open the questions now. Okay, so this is sample final examination April 2019, but I'm going to discuss question 2B and 2C, okay? So I have explained a simple example on previous class. So I'm going to read the two questions here. Okay. So the one that highlighted now, we are going to identify what types of the variable. Okay. Then another one questions here. Okay. So now, for question B. Okay, so when network cards are communicating, bits can occasionally be corrupted in transmission. Engineers have determined that the number of bits in error has a mean of 3.2 bits per kilobyte. Okay, so see that here, number of bits is a discrete variable. Okay. It is referred to the counting number. Okay, so we have 1 bit, 2 bits, 3 bits, and so on. Therefore, in this case, our x, which represent or which means the discrete variable, is denoted by number of bits. So for this situation, it has mean of 3.2 bits per kilobyte. Okay, we see that this number of bits based on in error. So it happened will be in the times actually, because stated here when network cards are communicating, so it means that it happens in some duration, even though we cannot identify whether the durations in a minute or so on. Okay, but there is a time, or there is a factor of time in the situation. Okay, so therefore for B, it is a Poisson probability distribution. Okay, so now look at these questions. C, the probability of successfully landing of a plane using a flight simulator is given as 0.8. So 9 randomly and independently chosen student pilots are asked to try to fly the plane using the simulator. Okay, so for this situation, we can see that when it's mentioned successfully landing, okay, so we have one situation, another one situation, even though it's not mentioned, okay, that is not successfully landing. So this situation form the binomial probability distribution. Okay, so whereby the p-value is 0.8, so q is 0.2. Okay, so for C, it is a binomial probability distribution. Okay, so since we have identified, okay, now we go back to a situation in question B. Since we have identified that question 2B here is a Poisson, okay, then we proceed by writing down the Poisson probability function. Okay, so we are going to write down here the information is given. Okay, when it's mentioned has a mean of 3.2 bits kilobyte, so this is our lambda value. Okay, so since we have identified number of bits is x, okay, so this is our x case. Okay, so this means when x is 5, when x is 8, no error means x is equal to 0. So now we will solve it. Okay, so first rewrite down. Okay, we are going to write down the probability function. So the probability function is so Poisson, right? E to the power negative lambda, lambda to the power x divided by x factorial. Okay, so we identify first this is mean, so this is our lambda. Okay, so for question part 1, evaluate their probability when 5 bits being in error during the transmission of 1 kilobyte. So this is one we refer. So for 1 kilobyte, the lambda is 3.2, which is here. Okay, so when we want to find when px equal to 5, so this means we are using this case. Okay, then we have 3.2 to the power of 5 divided by 5 factorial. Okay, so this time you can check the value in your calculator. Okay, so we have 0.114. Okay, for example, if we round off the value correct to 3 decimal places, so the value is 0.114. In part 2, we have 8 bits being in error during the transmission of 2 kilobyte. Okay, so we have 1 kilobyte, the lambda value as 3.2, then for 2 kilobyte, okay, so you have to find the new value of lambda. Okay, so this one okay, we have 6.4. Okay, so we are going to use this lambda value 6.4 because the questions refer for the transmission of 2 kilobyte. Okay, so to answer part 2, we are going to evaluate when x is equal to 8 and we use the same probability function for the Poisson. So we have e to the power negative 6.4 times 6.4 to the power of 8 divided by 8 factorial. Okay, so now you can check the value in your calculator. And get 0.116. Okay, correct. If it's correct to 3 decimal places. Again, now for part 3, no error bits in 3 kilobyte. Okay, so this time the transmissions is in 3 kilobyte. So we have 3 kilobyte here. Okay, so for 3 kilobyte, we have lambda of 9.6. Okay, so for part 3, no error bits mean when x equal to 0. Then we use the probability function. Okay, we have negative 9.6 times 9.6 power 0, then divided by 0 factorial. So 0 factorial is 1. Okay, so this time we can write down as 6.77 times 10 to the power negative 5. Okay, so this is the notations in scientific notation. Okay, so if you have any questions, okay, for this part B, please leave your message to me. Okay, now we go to the next question. Okay, so this question C, we have identified that the probability is a binomial. Okay. Okay, so this is a binomial probability distribution. So we write down first the probability function, okay, for this binomial as follow. So the one in this bracket means NCX. Okay, so this is a value of P. So the value of Q is 1 minus 0.8. So we have 0.2. So please take note that P plus Q is equal to 1. Okay, because in binomial, there are exactly two outcomes. Therefore, they must fulfill the complement rule. Okay, so this non-randomly is our n value. Next, we want to find question part 1. Okay, find the probability that all students successfully land the plane using the simulator. So means we want to find all students. We have X that is equal to 9. Okay, because our n value is 9, therefore all students means the amount, the number of students is 9. Okay, so we have 9. So this, the one in the bracket means 9C9. Okay, now we have 0.8 to the power of 9. Then we have 0.2 to the power of 0. Okay, so now get the value in your calculator. So key in 9C9. Okay, then times 0.8 to the power of 9. So 0.2 to the power 0 is equal to 1. So the value is 0.1342. Okay, this is if we round off correct to 4 decimal places. Okay, next question part 2. None of the students pilot lands the plane using the simulator. So means this is when X is 0. Okay, so we have 9, 0, 0.8 power 0, then 0.2 power 9. See? So we use this probability function. Okay, check the value in your calculator. 9C0 is equal to 1. Okay, and then times 0.2 to the power of 9. So we have this value as 5.12 times 10 to the power negative 7. So this one, the numbers is represented in scientific notation. Okay, there is a last question here. At least 8 of students pilot successfully land the plane using the simulator. So I'm going to write down again the function. So our P just now is 0.8, Q is 0.2. Okay, when you said here, or stated at least eight students, okay? So we have to represent this as interval. Okay, when it's mentioned at least eight, so means that eight is the minimum. Okay, eight is the minimum, so we represented like this. Okay, so means that it will be 8 students and 9 students, because 9 is also at least 8. Okay, 7, 6, 5 and so on will not be included in the interval. Okay, so when write down here, the one in the probability function, so we have write this. Okay, so we represented the interval into discrete value that is equal to 8 and 9. Okay, so take note that just now our n is 9, right? 9 students. Okay, so instead at least 8, so this is 8 is the minimum, so including 9. Okay, so 8 and 9. So we represented this one. So we separate the value into a discrete one. Okay, so the one that we have find out just now, this one, we already find out in question part 1. Okay, so I will just get the value from previous calculation. That is 0.1342, which is here. Okay, 0.1342. Okay, so here I will just write down. So we have 0.1342. So I need to find out is this value. Okay, so I written this part as 9, 8. Follow the probability function. So we have 0.8 power 8, 0.2 power 1. Okay, then they will be add with this one. Okay, so I'm going to calculate first for probability when x equal to 8. So 9C8 is 9. Okay, so we need to multiply with 0.8 to the power of 8 times 0.2. So I have 0.30. Okay, if it's correct to 4 decimal places. So this gives us 0.4362. Final answer. Okay, so again, if you have any questions, okay, so don't forget to ask me.